Hello children, welcome back to 9th standard science class. In the last class we have worked out some problems of the exercise. Let us continue. Some more problems are there. Take out page number 112 and you write problems from the textbook. First problem we have already worked out and fourth problem we have worked out. Now let us see second problem. Joseph jogs from one end A to other end B of a straight 300 meter road in 2 minutes 30 seconds and then turns around and jogs 100 meter back to point C in another 1 minute. What are Joseph's average speeds and velocities in jogging A from A to B and from A to C? What is given here? The distance he covered and time taken given from A to B of a straight road. So that 300 meters he jogs in 2 minutes 30 seconds from A to B. Then turns around and jogs 100 meter back to point C. He turns around and come back to C. 100 meters back to point C in another 1 minute. What you have to find out? What are Joseph's average speeds and velocities in jogging A from A to B and B from A to C? Let us work out the problem. Let us write what is given. What is given here? From A to B, the distance covered is given. So, problem number 2, page 112. The distance covered from A to B. So, what it is? 300 meters. Then, in what time he covered this distance? Time is 2 minutes 30 seconds. So, time T is given. Time T is 2 minutes 30 seconds. Means convert it into seconds. 2 minutes means 60 into 2. 120 seconds. 2 minutes means 2 into 60. 1 minute is 60 seconds plus 30 seconds. Plus 30 seconds means how much? 120 plus 30, 150 seconds. So 300 meters he jogs taking 150 seconds. Now let us calculate average speed VAB. Average speed must be found out. In the first case, it is from A to B. First one, from A to B. Distance covered you have to find. Average speed VAB is equal to total distance covered divided by total time taken. Total distance covered divided by total time taken. Time taken. So you need distance traveled and total time taken. What is it? That is equal to total distance covered is 300 meters divided by total time taken is 150 seconds. That is equal to 2 meter per second. So what is the average speed? It is 2 meter per second. Now from A to B, you have to find average velocity. For that you need displacement. What is the displacement here? To find average velocity, you need the displacement. Displacement from A to B is 300 meter only. So what is the displacement from A to B? The displacement You have to find average velocity. For that you need displacement. From A to B we are calculating. Displacement is also 300 meters. So what is the time taken? Time taken is 150 seconds. Time T is 150 seconds. So what is average speed, velocity? Average velocity is equal to average velocity is equal to displacement by time taken. Displacement by time taken. What is the displacement? Displacement is also 300 meters divided by time taken is 150 seconds. So what is the velocity? Velocity is also 2 meter per second. So the first one, now we have found out speed. So average speed of the person who jogs from A to B, that is 2 meter per second. So average speed is 2 meter per second and average velocity is also 2 meter per second. Now let us find another from A to C. Another situation is given, distance covered from A to C. A to C, what is the distance covered? See, he jogs from A to B 300 meters and from B he turns around and comes back to C. Comes back to C. How much distance he covered? 100 meters. Comes back to C. Now you have to find the average speed of the person who is jogging from A to C. How he came to C? He comes from A to B, turns around and 100 more meters he covers and reaches C. So let us find out now from A to C. What is the distance covered from A to C? A to C means from A to B 300 meters plus from B to C, he turns around and reaches C by covering 100 more meters. So 300 plus 100 meters, that is equal to 400 meters. So what is the distance covered from A to C? It is 400 meters. Now let us find out the average speed. Therefore, time taken is, say time T, let us write, time T is equal to, from A to B, he takes 150 seconds plus one more minute he takes to cover 100 more meters and reaches C. So 1 minute means how many seconds? 60 seconds. So from A to B, 150 seconds and from B to C, he took 1 more minute. Means here, 2 minutes to cover this distance, he took 2 minutes 30 seconds. And 100 more meter to cover, 1 more minute he took. 1 minute means 60 seconds. So what is the total time taken? 150 seconds plus 60 seconds. That is 210 seconds. So what is the time taken? 210 seconds. Now therefore, average speed is equal to total distance covered divided by total time taken. So that is equal to, now total distance covered how much? 400 meters. From A to C it is 400 meters.
and the time taken is 210 seconds. That is equal to, simplify, 00 cancelled, 40 by 21. How much you get? 40 by 21. It is nothing but 1.90 meter per second. So what is the average speed? It is 1.90 meter per second. So simplify, you get 1.90 meter per second. Now let us find out the average velocity. What is the average velocity? You need here the displacement. What is the displacement? To find the average velocity, you need the displacement. Displacement is here 300 meters he travels and comes back to sea. So what is the displacement? It is nothing but 300 minus 100 meters, that is 200 meters. So what is displacement? Displacement is equal to 300 from A to B, 300 meters, minus from B to C, 100 meters. That is equal to 200 meters. Now you can find what is the time taken. Time taken is 210 seconds only. So the time t is equal to 210 seconds. Now find the average velocity. Average velocity is equal to displacement by time. Displacement, total displacement, divided by total time. Total displacement divided by total time. What is the displacement here? Displacement is 200 meters divided by, what is the time taken? 210 seconds. 210 seconds. Simplify, 20 divided by 21. It is nothing but 0.925 meter per second. So what is the average velocity? It is 0.925 meter per second. I hope you have understood. Try to understand. From A to B, he jogs taking 2 minutes 30 seconds and turns around and comes to C by covering 100 meters. So you have to find out the average speed and average velocity. So this is how the problem is solved. Now let us move on to the next problem. Problem number, exercise C, problem number 3. Abdul, while driving to school, computes the average speed for his trip to be 20 km per hour. So, while driving to school, he computes the average speed is given. How much it is? 20 km per hour. On his return trip, along the same route, there is less traffic and the average speed is 30 km per hour. What is the average speed for Abdul's trip? So here it is given, while going to school, he computed the speed of 20 km per hour. On his return trip, along the same route, there was less traffic and the average speed is 30 km per hour. What is the average speed for Abdul's trip? How to find the average speed for Abdul's trip? Now, let us consider, the distance is not given here. Let the distance be x meter in for both the trips. For one journey and for the return journey. For both the trips, the distance covered, let us consider as x meter. Now let us solve the problem. Third problem solution. What? Let the distance covered be x. The x meter. Now, what is given there? Speed is given. Average speed. It is first one journey and then to return journey, let us write. Average speed VAV is given 20 km per hour. Now what is the time taken? Let us consider is 51 for one journey is equal to, see, you know that V is equal to S by T. What is S? Distance covered. V means speed is equal to S, distance covered by time taken. So now we want T. So T is equal to S by V. So what is T? T is equal to S by V. Now let us write here, S we have considered as X meter divided by T1, V, S by V. V is 20 km per hour. So time T is X by 20 seconds. I hope you have understood. You know that speed V is given by distance covered S by time T. We want time T is equal to distance covered divided by speed. So speed is given there. Distance covered we have taken as X. So it is X by 20 seconds. Now let us write for second instance. This is first second instance, let us write. The distance covered for return trip. It is for return trip. Distance covered, let us consider as X meter. And speed, average speed is given for return trip. Average speed for return trip is given 30 km per hour. And what is the time? Time T 2. Let us consider it as time T 2. So the same formula consider. T2 is equal to S by V. S is X divided by V is 30 seconds. So T2 is X by 30 seconds. Now let us find out the average speed VAV. How to find the average speed VAV? Let us find the average speed. VAV is equal to what? Total distance covered divided by total time taken. Total distance covered or total distance divided by total time. What is the total distance here? For one trip it is, see, X meter. For the next trip it is X meter. So what is the total distance covered? X plus X divided by total time taken is T1 plus T2. T1 plus T2. Now let us find T1 plus T2. Here we have found T1 and T2. Let us find, later let us work out this. Now T1 plus T2 is equal to, what is T1? It is X by 20 plus
T2 is x by 30. So what is it? X plus x, 2x divided by, you know how to, 20. The common denominator is 60. So x into 3 into 2 into 2. So what is it? What is it now? That is equal to 3x plus 2x divided by, the common denominator is 60. So t1 plus t2 is 3x plus 2x. How much it is? 5x divided by 60. Now 5 ones are 5, 12s are. So what is it now? X by 12. So t1 plus t2 is x by 12. Now we have got, what is t1 plus t2? It is x by 12. Now let us take the formula and substitute x plus x. How much? X plus x is 2x divided by t1 plus t2 is x by 12. So try to understand, x plus x, it is 2x divided by t1 plus t2 is x by 12. So you know that division is the inverse of multiplication. So how to write this? 2x into inverse this, 12 by x. X, x gets cancelled, 12 to the 24 kilometer per hour. So what is the average speed of Abdul's trip? It is 24 kilometer per hour. I hope you have understood the problem. First let us consider the distance covered as x meter. Speed is given. In both the cases let us consider the distance covered as x meter, so that you get the formula total distance covered x plus x divided by total time taken t1 plus t2. T1 plus t2, you know, t1 is x by 20 plus t2 is x by 30. So it is nothing but x by 12. X plus x is 2x divided by x by 12. That means 2x into 12 by x. X, x gets cancelled. It is 24 kilometer per hour. So that completes the second problem. Write it down in your class workbook. Now let us move on to another problem. See, look page number 130, seventh problem. Let us work out page number 130, seventh problem. Look at the problem. A ball is gently dropped from a height of 20 meter. If its velocity increases uniformly at the rate of 10 meter per second square, with what velocity will it strike the ground? After what time will it strike the ground? You have to find the time also and you have to find the velocity also. What is given here? Initial velocity u. You know it starts from rest, so u is 0 meter per second, and the distance covered is 20 meter. Distance covered is 20 meter. If its velocity increases uniformly at the rate of 10 meter per second square, means what is given? Acceleration is given. It is 10 meter per second square. So what you have to find? You have to find velocity also and with what time it strikes to the ground. Time also. Let us find the time first. How to find the time? Let us see now. Solution. What is given right first? What is given? Distance travelled is given. Yes. Distance travelled. Travelled, x is given, is equal to
20 meter. And what else is given? Initial velocity u is given. U is equal to initial velocity u is 0 meter per second. And acceleration is given. Acceleration A is equal to 10 meter per second square. 10 meter per second square. So what you have to find? You have to find time t and also velocity v. Velocity v must be found out. Now let us consider how to find time t. See, what formula do you use? You know the three equations of motion. According to the data given, you can use the formula. So you know s, you know a, you know. You have to find t. So which formula can be used? S is equal to ut plus half a t square. Every time write the formula. S is equal to ut plus half a t square. Let us find time now. S is given how much? 20 meter. That is equal to u is 0 into t plus half into a is given 10 into t square. Now 0 into t, 0. 20 is equal to 2 ones are 2 fives are. So how much is remaining? 20 is equal to 5 t square. T square is equal to 20 by 5. So that is 4. Then what is t? T is equal to square root of 4. T square is 4. So what is t? T is equal to square root of 4. That is equal to 2 seconds. So what is the time you have found out? It is 2 seconds. Now let us find velocity. How to find velocity? With the given data. Now you know time 2 seconds, acceleration is given and initial velocity is given. What you have to find? You have to find v. So which formula can be used? V is equal to u plus a t. V is equal to u plus a t. So now that is equal to u is how much? 0 plus a is 10 meter per second square into t you have found 2 seconds. So that is equal to 20 meter per second. So what is velocity v? It is nothing but 20 meter per second. Did you understand how to solve the problem? Both you have to work out using the proper formula. So according to the data given, select the formula and find out. So first find t and then using v is equal to u plus a t, find v. So this is how the problem can be worked out. Now the last problem, let us move on to just I give you the formula, you work out in the classwork. See, 10th problem. An artificial satellite is moving in a circular orbit of radius 42,250 kilometer. Calculate its speed if it takes 24 hours to revolve around the earth. So what is given? Distance is given 42,250. It is moving in a circular orbit and it takes 24 hours to revolve around the earth. What you have to find? Calculate its speed in 24 hours. So what formula you use? Radius is given. Radius of the circus is given. How much? 42,250 kilometer. 250 kilometer. Then time t is given 24 hours. Time t 24 hours given.
So convert it into seconds. 24 hours is equal to 24 into 60 into 60. Now this also you have to convert into meter when you convert this into seconds. Now speed v should be found out. Speed v should be found out. So what is it? If you are calculating in kilometer per hour, calculate as it is. Now distance v is, speed v is equal to distance divided by time. So what is the distance here? Pi r square, 2 pi r by t. Distance is, it is a circular path, so distance is 2 pi r divided by t. Substitute and calculate. Let us find the answer in the next class. You try to work out the problem. See you. Thank you.